You know, to be honest with you guys, I never want to say that I absolutely hate a genre of music as a whole. Yeah, I'm not the biggest fan of indie rock. Like, I don't think it's bad, but admittedly, it's not my favorite type of music. But there are a good selection of indie rock bands that I would put on, like, on a high pedestal, like Imagine Dragons or Jukebox the Ghost. And hell, even some genres I used to despise really grew on me, like rap and country. Hell, for rap, I'm a huge fan of rap nowadays because of my love for nu metal. So I can't say I hate one genre as a whole. Except when it comes to crunkcore.
You got a problem, bitch? Throw your hands up. It's you against me. This shit is one-on-one.
Crunkcore is a style of scene music that combines electronic dance music with the screaming of what you would expect from, say, a screamo band, though there are some exceptions that don't scream at all. And I'm gonna be completely honest with you guys, there is no crunkcore act that I could say I truly like. Blood on the Dance Floor? Unicorns Kill My Girlfriend? Don't like them. Like, if there is a crunkcore act that you think I would like that I don't know about, feel free to recommend them to me, but admittedly, these groups didn't give me the best first impression. Though, the main act we'll be focusing on in this video was BrokenCYDE. BrokenCYDE is a crunkcore group that started in 2006 and is somehow still going to this day. In fact, they released an album in 2018, holy shit. Anyways, BrokenCYDE released their first album in 2009. I'm not a fan, but the kids like it. This album has been not well received, boy, lately. But does this album deserve all the hate it got? Well, let's review it to see if you should be a fan, whether the kids like it or not. This is a 40-second intro filled with what I can only assume to be lasers and a bunch of other bullshit. Honestly, it's boring as fuck and just, well, the lazy inevitable bad music that awaits. Freaks is definitely a song that shows off everything wrong with this album, but it's technically a song. For starters, the mix of screamed vocals and techno-club beats do not mesh well, especially when they're shoved in the middle of auto-tune madness. Look, I don't really have a problem with auto-tune as a whole, as long as it still sounds good, but yeah, that doesn't exactly apply here. Most of the synced vocals on this entire album are shoved through auto-tune, and the auto-tune doesn't even sound good. Like, guys, if you can't sing, like, you didn't have to. Then there's the lyrics. Yeah, they're bad. See, for BrokenCYDE in particular, they have two points of interest: partying and having dirty sex. There you go, you got their entire career in a nutshell. Now, just to be clear, I don't have a problem with songs about sex. Hell, some examples of bands and artists that have done good songs about the subject are Red Hot Chili Peppers, Motorhead, and, well, pretty much half of the rappers I like. The problem with this song's lyrics, and so many of this album, is that the lyrics sound like they were written by fucking virgins. And I should know all about songs written by virgins, heyo! But seriously though, the lyrics are fucking terrible. And they do it throughout the entire album. Shoot me. Okay, I'm gonna be real with you. Who the fuck uses sex as a verb? Like, what in the world made you think that was a good idea? Oh, but I mean, it didn't even work in that song, so it's still a terrible line. And near the end of the song, they start randomly screaming
liar
for literally no goddamn reason. Because, yeah, this song has definitely been about someone being a liar this entire time. You know, I mean, can you notice it? Overall, Freaks is a terrible opening song, though I do have to warn you, it's actually one of the better ones compared to what we'll see later on. At least this one is catchy, but the other songs, I mean, this is crunkcore. We are pretty much guaranteed a song with skeets somewhere in this album. Thanks a lot, Little John. Though, honestly, I don't know why they didn't make this Freaks Part 2, because honestly, nothing really separates that song and Ski Ski apart stylistically or lyrically, except, I guess, more references to sex. As if we needed more of that in now, where it's pretty much a gimmick to be so in-your-face about it. And, of course, more dumb lines. I like how the guy screaming seems to realize how stupid the line is, so it doesn't sound like he's saying beep, and it just sounds like he trailed off at the end saying, guys, do we really need to make this a part of the hook? Because it sounds stupid. And honestly, I would have listened to him in that regard. Yeah, if I was in this girl's place, I'd be pretty fucking scared, especially since you're screaming in my face that you have a 12-inch dick, which is obviously hard to believe, not gonna lie. Overall, this song sucks as well.
Hey girl, why don't you come over and suck this daddy dick?
What the fuck, Arnar? What the fuck did you just say, dog?
Yay, a pointless skin. Yay,
fucking kill me.
This skit is just filler, plain and simple. It's pretty much just a guy wanting to call his girl to ask if she wants a daddy dick, but accidentally calls a guy, and honestly, this is some of the most fucking forced dialogue and terrible acting that I've ever heard.
You want me to suck that daddy dick off? You think I'm a fucking faggot, dog? I'll fucking beat the shit out of you, homie. This is normal kicking. Kings, homie. Blaze one, loco.
Oh, skits and albums are fine. Hell, some rap albums that I really like have skits, like Eminem's Relapse or Kanye West's Late Registration. But the difference in those albums is that the skits were either well acted and or served a purpose of some kind. Here, it's just... Actually, hold that thought for a second, because we'll get to that in a bit. Though, point is, this skit is just filler that didn't need to be here. Oh, I get it now. The reason why a skit came before this one was because it was called Late Night Call, and this song is called Booty Call. Yeah, because we definitely need cringy acting to lead into a cringy song. Yeah, that definitely doesn't make the song worse or anything. Needless to say, Booty Call also sucks. It's the same old bullshit from the previous songs, with such thought-provoking lines such as, "Shake it like some chocolate milk," or "Jolly Rancher's sugar daddy's chocolate-covered booty panties." Fucking ugh. But this one features E40, so at least we get a decent guest verse, right? No, we really fucking don't. E40's guest verse is on the same level with the guys in BrokenCYDE, which is fucking sad coming from a rapper with actual talent like E40. Like, come on, dude. I expected this shit from the other guys, but this? Have a few drinks to get sloppy, sloppy. Drunk. Girl, you got a big old dog. Look at all the junk in your trunk. I like the way you lay it. Should not be acceptable by anyone with half a brain cell. Overall, this song is another bust. And here we have the only single from this album, Get Crunk. Or maybe it's not, because the last time I checked, apparently Freaks is the only single, even though I could have sworn it was Get Crunk earlier, which... Guys, make up your fucking mind. But anyways, this song is different from the other songs in that all the lyrics are screamed, as opposed to the other ones which featured screaming but also had rapping and singing. Honestly, do you expect me to say that the song's good? Cause yeah, it's not. The screaming gets obnoxious after a minute or less cause it's so fucking monotone and it doesn't want to switch out of first gear because... partying. Also, this song repeats lyrics like a motherfucker, like, Jesus Christ, I want to hear, "Get Crunk!" or, "Put your crowds up!" on loop like a broken record. I get that this is some sort of party jam for whatever fucked up party would be drunk or high enough to play this underwhelming sack of mediocrity, but hearing the lyric over and over again doesn't mean I want to get crunk, as you say. It makes me want to find the window, jump out of it. The only redeeming factor about this song is that it's not about fucking this time. If that's the only good thing I can say about your song, then we have a problem right there. To get up in that butt, here's a list of bitches I fuck. Guys, I'm just gonna say this right now. This is the worst song on the album, in my opinion. Anything that you've heard up to this point has been small beans compared to Yellow Bus, because Yellow Bus is honestly one of the worst songs that I've ever heard. Let's start off with the beat. While I haven't mentioned much about BrokenCYDE's beats up to this point, I honestly think that they're not all that bad and they can be danced to. Too bad I shot all over them with terrible screaming and auto-tune up the ass, but at least they were good beats. Hell, for Booty Call, I actually really like the beat. I don't know why, it's just good to me. It's not a good song by any means, but it's definitely a good beat. This song has the least danciest beat ever, and it fucking sucks. Second, the hook. I can give credit to the likes of Freaks and Booty Call. At least they had hooks that felt like they could have worked if they ironed the cringe out. Here, this is one of the worst hooks for a song ever. First off, Don't make a song about fucking with any meeny miny mo in it, especially when it's gonna be the chorus. I'm pretty sure that these totally real bitches don't want you to recite the children decision-making process to them. Or was this just an attempt to have something rhyme with ho, which in that case, you do realize that there are other words that rhyme with ho, right? Second off, when you're making a hook, it's best not to sound like you've just been kicked in the balls, because the point of a hook is to be catchy and able to sing along to, especially when it's gonna be repeated multiple times. I highly doubt anyone is going to sing with all their pride, "Different state, a different ho!" And third, using sex as a verb wasn't clever in Freaks, what makes you think it's gonna be clever here? And of course, as usual, we have bad lyrics. Okay, I know this isn't technically a lyric, but can you try and not imitate moaning? Cause it's really fucking cringy when you do it. Anyways, continue on. Here's a list of bitches I fucked. Madonna, Cassandra, Quintana, Kiana, your mama, Brandy, and Sandy, Mandy, Melissa, Rashad, Candy, Jessica, Sarah, Jack. Oh my god. Were these lyrics made by a 12-year-old on Xbox Live? No, scratch it. Even a 12-year-old will be able to come up with better lyrics than this shit. First off, you guys ain't gangster. You're about as gangster as a piece of paper. Second, this song is about wanting to fuck groupies. I don't know why you suddenly brought up how tough you are out of nowhere. And third, look out guys, we got a badass over here. He has a white t-shirt. You don't want to fuck with the guy with a white t-shirt. He'll go kick your ass. Do you see my point about this song literally being the worst thing ever? I hope you have, because we're moving on from this. At least this song isn't as bad as Yellow Bus, though to be fair, anything could be better than that pile of shit, but really the song sucks. What a surprise. Same boring lines about fucking, corny lines, like seriously, who the fuck asked girl to do the salt shaker? Like, I've heard shake it like a salt shaker, but literally no one on earth says do the salt shaker. The salt shaker? And of course, an underwhelming guest appearance, this time being Daddy X of Cottonmouth Kings, who does the exact same shit that BrokenCYDE has been doing throughout this album. Honestly, I don't know why he wasn't ran out of the song entirely and replaced with one of the BrokenCYDE crew, cause honestly, Daddy X doesn't really add much except another voice in an album of garbage. He blends in so much with BrokenCYDE that if you were to tell me that he was a member of the group, I honestly wouldn't be able to tell. So really, his feature was absolutely pointless. I'm sorry, X, but you just didn't give it to you. Also, the hook sucks too. Hearing the constant repetition of "get up off your feet" gets grating after 3 seconds. Doesn't help with the fucking pitch shift. Honestly, this song is yet another fail. Wow, a song that isn't complete garbage? What a fucking relief. 9 tracks in, and we finally have a song that is somewhat redeemable. Is it perfect? Is it even good? No, of course not. But at least we have a decent hook, a decent beat, a decent flow. It's just decent. Though, the screaming still sucks though, but hey, it sucked out the entire album, what were you expecting? Also, the subject matter of the song is insulting. People are jealous of you guys? Yeah, cause I'm so jealous of the guys that made fucking Yellow Bus. Is this song good? Like I said, no. But is it better than the other garbage you had to go through? Hell yes. Hey guys.
Let's get poppin', let's get poppin', 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 poppin'.
Okay, seriously, what the fuck is this hook? This fucking sucks. Who thought this was a good idea? Was it this guy? Did you do it? Fuck you. Though, in all seriousness, this song is pretty much just a copy of the other sex song on this album. Poppin' is pretty much in the same ballpark as Skeet Skeet, in that it literally has nothing that makes it a solid song that should stand on its own. Let alone a song that I should come back to. Like, why was this song on this album? Was this just here to fill out album space? So, I'll take that as a yes? Poppin' Part 2 definitely sucks, and yes, I refuse to call the song a different name from the last one, because this album is getting fucking monotonous. Needless to say, this song is nothing but filler. Nothing to hold your attention, just the same old fucking bullshit. And I feel like I'm repeating myself because I just brought this up with Poppin'. There's like one admittedly funny line about punching babies, but that's fucking it. We're repeating the same old tired sex and party songs that plagued this album, and there's more lyrics about getting so drunk and high that they definitely fuck bitches, guys. It's the same old bullshit. Overall, Poppin' Part 2 sucks. Wow, I didn't expect that. That was sarcasm, by the way. Fucking ugh. I'll give Poppin' Parts 1 and 2 this. At least they were just fucking boring. This song is pretty much solely made to make you fucking cringe all the way through. Mainly because of the stupid-ass fucking lyrics like, "You make my pee-pee hard." Okay, this should be a rule for rappers everywhere. Unironically referring to your dick as a pee-pee automatically takes away any hope of being able to take you seriously. At least with Eminem's ass like that, the song was funny and immature, so it would make sense in that context, but here, it's done by a couple of virgins, unironically. Also, can I just point out how the song is called Sex Toys, but literally no sex toys are actually mentioned? Like, is that just me? Am I the only one who noticed that? I mean, it's not like it makes the song worse or anything. I mean, it's hard to ruin something that's already ruined. But like, am I the only one who knows that? Oh god, what the fuck even is this song? Is this BrokenCYDE actually trying to get serious? As if I'm buying that bullshit. I will give the song this. It's at least different from anything up to this point, but like, that doesn't make this song good. This song tries its damnedest to try and make you feel sad for BrokenCYDE during this depressed song, and honestly, it's as fake as homophobes actually being smart in the visuals. Not to mention, this nondescript is all hell. The song seems to be describing someone who is apologizing to their lover for something that he did that's never really explained. He does say that he fucked up this girl's life, but like, how did this happen? Nothing is explained as to what this guy did to make this girl hate him. It's like they wanted to write a song apologizing to a lover, but forgetting what the guy is actually supposed to be apologizing about. Oh yeah, and the girl is referred to as a fucking bitch in the intro, so this entire song just comes off as backhanded. I'm not saying you can have a ballad-type song. Hell, sometimes they're fucking great. But when it's written this fucking bad and is so fucking disingenuous, it's at that point where I'm just like, why should I take this seriously? And then there's a hidden track at the end of the album. It's basically a bunch of clips with people saying that they wanted I'm Not a Fan to be a good album, but it was really bad.
I don't know what else to say. The record just, like, it just didn't turn out the way I wanted it to. I wanted it to be good. And it's not.
Fucking BrokenCYDE? These guys better sell some fucking records and make all this fucking shit worth it. Crunk and Screamo? What the fuck are people thinking out there?
Which, I mean, yeah, I perfectly agree wholeheartedly, people I don't know. Wait, does this mean that this entire time, BrokenCYDE knew that they were making a bad album, but still decided to release it anyway? Fuck it, I'm done with this bullshit. Final thoughts on this album. I think it's one of the worst albums I've ever heard. Say what you want to about Corey Feldman's angelic to the core, at least I can see that it actually had care and effort put into it. Hell, Corey spent 10 goddamn years recording the entire thing. Hell, despite its numerous failings, I won't deny that there are some songs I genuinely like from that album. One example being the song Mercy. Say what you want to about Lou Reed and Metallica's Lulu, and trust me, there's a lot you could say right there, but at least the riffs were good, and the lyrics went into some interesting subject matters. Say what you want to about LMFAO's Sorry for Party Rocking. At least the album had a few good songs and actually felt like it had passion put into it. With this album, I can't even defend it as a whole. There's like one song that isn't all the way garbage, but that's fucking it. The rest of the songs are fucking stupid ass sex songs that aren't even shocking, they're just immature and stupid. I get the immature shit can be done well, but these guys don't do it well at all. And before anyone says, oh, these guys just made these songs bad on purpose as a joke, so ha, take that. Good job, you actively made a bad album that's gonna be ripped to shreds by music critics everywhere from the ungodly abomination that it is. Who do you think is gonna enjoy this? Masochists? Trolls? I don't fucking know. Is it the worst album I've ever heard? Hell no, we live in a universe where this, and this exists. And especially this album. Fuck this album. If you want to hear crunkcore that's worse than BrokenCYDE, here you go. Anyways, this is Mitch Slayer, signing out.